हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ सौरभ देशमुख, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, वॉल्चन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी द डायरेक्ट फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ यूनिएक्सियल एलिमेंट यूजिंग मैट्रिक्स मेथड. द लर्निंग आउटकम्स एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन, द लर्नर विल एबल टू सॉल्व यूनिएक्सियल एलिमेंट प्रॉब्लम एनालिटिकली यूजिंग मैट्रिक्स मेथड. So we are going to solve a simple step bar problem. You will find here three step bars. One is of area 300 mm square, second is of area 200 mm square, and third is of cross sectional area 90 mm square. And the length of first bar is 200 mm, the length of second bar is 400 mm, and the length of third bar is 300 mm. The one end of the bar is fixed supported. And from other end, we are applying a tensile force of 50 kilonewton. Okay, so we'll write first the given data. The area of first bar, we'll call it as A1. Okay, so A1 equals to, it is 300 mm square. The area of second bar, suppose it is A2, equals to, it is 200 mm square, and A3, it is 90 mm square. Okay, the length of first bar is L1 equals to 200 mm, L2, it is 400 mm, and L3, it is 300 mm. Okay, we'll take a material as a simple structural steel of Young's modulus E equals to 200 gigapascal. We'll convert it into Newton per mm square, so it will be 2 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square. Okay, and the applied force is, of course, here we have written it, F equals to 50 kilonewton. Okay, so first of all, we'll convert this step bar into a single line bar line problem. So this is the fixed support, and the first bar will present by first line. Okay, here is this end point of this bar, then we'll start the second line for to represent the second bar, and then third. Okay, so we'll apply here force F equals to 50 kilonewton. Okay, so we have converted it into a line problem. So this is the first node, this is second node, or we'll call it as a key point here. This is third key point, and this is fourth key point. Okay, so we'll now calculate the element stiffness matrix. We denote it by letter K. So for first bar, we will say it is K1, for second bar K2, and third bar it is K3. Okay, so we'll calculate it. K1 equals to, its formula is A1 E1 by L1 into the matrix 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Okay, so we'll substitute here the values, respective values, that is 300 into E is 2 into 10 raised to 5 upon L1, it is 200 mm. This matrix is called as distribution matrix. So 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. So we'll calculate it, it will get cancelled, 0 will get cancelled. So 3 into 10 raised to 5, that is 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Okay, so we'll just insert it, these values into the matrix. So keep 10 raised to 5 outside the matrix only, just sake of calculation convenience. So 10 raised to 5 into 3 minus 3 minus 3 3. ओके वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड दिस फॉर फर्स्ट एलिमेंट के वन. सिमिलरली वी विल गो फॉर द सेकंड एलिमेंट दैट इज के टू. ओके सो आई विल जस्ट शिफ्ट हियर. नाउ वी विल कैलकुलेट इट फॉर के टू इक्वल्स टू. सिमिलरली विल गेट द वैल्यूज फॉर द सेकंड बार. सो ए टू ई टू अपॉन एल टू इंटू द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मैट्रिक्स वन माइनस वन माइनस वन वन. सो वील सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज हियर. ए टू इक्वल्स टू 200 इंटू ई टू द यंग्स मॉडुलस ऑफ सेकंड बार इज वी आर सिलेक्टिंग द सेम एलिमेंट. सो सेम मटेरियल हियर. सो दैट विल बी 2 इंटू 10 रेस टू 5 अपॉन एल टू इट इज 400 इंटू 1 माइनस 1 माइनस 1 1 equals to it will get cancelled 2 to 0 also. So it will be 1 into 10 raised to 5 into minus 1 oh sorry just here 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Okay, so just it will be same matrix as it is because we are multiplying by 1. So for k3 now equals to a3 e3 by l3 into the distribution matrix 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 so equals to we'll substitute the values of third bar here. So that will be 90 into it is 2 into 10 raised to 5 upon 300. So into the stiffness matrix 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Okay, so it will become 0 will get cancelled. I guess it is 0.6 into 10 raised to 5 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. So it will be we will multiply 0.6 into the matrix. So 10 raised to 5 at it is 0.6 minus 0.6 minus 0.6 and 0.6. So we have calculated the stiffness element matrix for each element. So for the first element, the second element and the third element here. Okay, so now we'll formulate the global stiffness matrix. Okay, so for the global stiffness matrix, it is shown by K. Okay, I will write it here. Global stiffness matrix K equals to it is very simple to formulate the global stiffness matrix from the element stiffness matrix. Just there are four nodes, okay, four key points. So the global stiffness matrix is of order 4 by 4. Okay, so see here how we formulate the global stiffness matrix. First write K1, then minus K1. Okay, minus K1. Okay, for the first row, second row and first column and second column, we have written the stiffness, the element stiffness matrix of first element. Okay, so just we have to continue it for the third, second and third element. Okay, so I will add it here K2. Okay, same here. What is here? So just 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. So K2 minus K2 now. This is also minus K2 and K2. And just add here in this K2 this stiffness element stiffness matrix of third element. So I will just add here plus K3 minus K3 minus K3 and K3. Just complete this matrix here. And the remaining parts or the element of the matrix will be 0. You just write it 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and 0. This is really simple to formulate the global. In this video, we have studied
how to form a global stiffness matrix. Now in next video, we will learn how to substitute the local stiffness values into global stiffness matrix and how to find the stresses, the strain and the deformation.
So these are the references. Thank you.